Anonymous. March against Monsanto in Kansas City from 10 to 3 p.m. There will be keynote speakers in Kansas City at Memorial Fountain. That'll be May 25th. There'll be a march against Monsanto in Knoxville, Tennessee at Market Square, 1 to 3 p.m. There will be marches across the world against Monsanto. Monsanto is trying to genetically hijack our very food stocks through genetically modified foods, or otherwise known as GMOs. This is going to be the final net over the people of the world when they control the very genetics of the food that we place into our bodies. Aristotle wrote that in Athens, when democracy was first founded, and he was no fan of democracy, that when it started, there were the haves and the have-nots, the oligarchs, and those who had nothing. We would call the oligarchs the 1% today. And at first, the people had nothing, no rights, not even the right to life itself. And they rebelled and demanded basic human rights and dignity and got them. And then the oligarchs, the 1%, began subverting these new institutions, and the people had to rebel again, and they demanded even more. And then once again, the oligarchs on the third revolution began subverting the basic newfound institutions of democracy, and the people rebelled again and demanded even more. And with each rebellion, they developed this concept that we call democracy through a series of 8 revolutions. Sound familiar? Our institutions, our democracy, where would you place ourselves in that cycle now? One fact is unarguable. You cannot talk about the history of democracy outside of the context of class warfare. Indeed, Aristotle would say that it's impossible, that it is a product of class warfare. The other lesson from Aristotle's essay, who, by the way, was no fan of this concept called democracy, was this cycle of democracy, of hijacking by special interest of the institutions of democracy for their own ends. Sound familiar? The greatest example that's happened where they've become so overt of the hijacking of the tools of our democracy was the smuggled in farmer assurance provision, also known as the Monsanto Protection Act, which allows the biotechnology giant to plant genetically modified crops before they've even been declared safe by the captured U.S. Department of Agriculture, and even can defy court orders. This is one of the greatest examples of the hijacking of our democracy. And the lesson from Athens, where the very concept of democracy was developed, is that people must rise to combat this cycle. Mobilize on May 25th, wherever you're at, march against Monsanto. Do not give in. This is part of the cycle of democracy. We get the democracy that we are willing to go to the streets and resist for. Also, from an anonymous side note, the environmental community has shown over decades the most steadfast commitment to nonviolence, despite overwhelming violence by police and corporate forces. In fighting mountaintop removal, they've been shot at, maced, had cars run over them. In the movements in the Northwest, they've been pain compliance, cattle prodded, and they've kept true to their commitment of nonviolence almost uniformly in public rallies and demonstrations. The greatest perpetrator of violence at public environmental rallies in North America has been the government, the state, the police, and the corporations themselves. Even so, remember, when you march, that the environmental community for decades has kept true to this commitment to nonviolence. And despite the fact that some of the organizers of the Monsanto, you know, protest on the 25th act as if they believe that, you know, there's even been a tiny bit of violence on behalf of environmentalists, that's not true. That's not our history. Show up, organize, and mobilize for the very future. For if we don't, soon it'll be too late. This is Anonymous. We are Legion, and we are mobilizing against Monsanto.